Greetings, ladies and gentlemen, to another Gwent deck video on my channel. To give you more unique decks instead of showing the same meta decks over and over again, we are exploring the card pool for Gwent further, introducing decks and cards that are not played that much right now. Today it is time for another Gales deck that I called Spam and Consume, because that is what the deck is all about. You're trying to spam the board with smallish units, absorb them, create bigger and bigger threats, and finally have a snack for your star gold card Kyrian that will destroy three loyal non-gold units and add their strength to this unit's base strength. So, to keep your board presence active, we're running the Nekas alongside one Neka Warrior. This should allow you to have at least one Neka hanging on the board for the whole game. For the consuming part, you have the Ghoul, this one, and you have the Nekimara active. Both units should be played when there's at least one Arrakath Behemoth on the board. This card will spawn one Arrakath whenever a unit is absorbed. A new Arrakath unit on the board will then also catch every Arrakath unit in your deck to the board, so you're literally getting four units for one absorb. More spamming can furthermore be done with the Gaunter Odim, which will give you three shadows. Each is dealing 1 point of damage to a non-god unit on your opponent's side of the field, as well as the Fire Elemental. The Elemental will produce one lesser Fire Elemental at the start of each of your turns, means the longer the game goes, the more stuff is on the board. If you are then happy with the board, you will activate Gale's Leader ability and buff everything to 6 points. Be aware of Geralt Igni and stuff like weather effects here, and don't go all in before you are on the safe side. One note on the Crones that I'm using. Instead of these three cards, you could of course also drop in the three Witchers. The Witchers are 2 points less, but not as vulnerable to a Geralt Igni. The reason why we are still running the Crones is that we want to split the board as much as possible. Having too many melee units will expose you to single weather lanes way harder. So much for the deck overview, and now it's time for some games.
Naivety's a fool's
plan. Our first game is against Foltest, so we might see some poor infantry spawn. We have the Neka here, Arrakath is definitely going into the deck. Neka as well. The Caretaker, which is fine. We have Ekimara, we have Arrakath Behemoth, Fire Elemental, Giant Toad, One Crone, Geralt Igni and the Kyran. That is all pretty good. We want to have a Neka Warrior here as well, so that's why we are dropping the Thunderbolt Potion. Hopefully not getting a bad card now. Last one is, that was bad. Another Crone. So took the risk and we lost. We might then draw another card with the Giant's Toad. We will drop one of the Crones. Getting rid of these 7 points. So the Giant Toad is to 12. We get the Gaunter here. And of course we will buff the Neka, which is a decent side effect. So he is playing with the poor infantries. That might be trouble. Go for the Fire Elemental for now. And spawn some lesser Fire Elementals each turn. Wind sign. Well, these are now protected. Always a pain. So let's drop the Arrakath Behemoth. You will then start to consume a bit with the Ekimara on the Arrakath. Yeah, he's going for the Muta again. That one's up to 7. Ekimara is eating. Let's see, we could go for one of the lesser Fire Elementals, but really want to use the Gale's ability, and we will spawn the Arrakath here in this lane. So we're taking down the Giant Toad. This will spawn before Arrakath. Neka is getting buffed to 5. There's another Muta again. So we should easily be able to win the first round here. Without a problem, we are ahead right now. And we're just going more ahead over the long run of the game. And we then might, if we win the round, we might just use the Caretaker to steal the 11 points poor infantry. So not a problem right now. Let's go for one of the Nekas here, drop that on the board.
Close ranks!
And unfortunately he's going for the Foltest, which means that he's spawning more 11 points, and even if we are stealing one then, he's taken one of the other 11 points units out of the graveyard. Not that great. Still, we are still able to win the round, no problem. Let's see, Chiron now? Probably not. Let's just go for the guilds here.
Naivety is a fool's blessing.
So we have 83 points. And unfortunately, weather effect is coming. Currently, we are tied. We will drop the Gaunter, which might kill one of the Reaver Hunters here. Yeah, we killed two. So we are 11 points ahead. Let's see how much he wants to invest here. We're still spawning one lesser fire elemental each turn. So increasing our stats by one each turn. There's Priscilla. Getting a field medic that is just spawning 1 point here. And the Reaver Hunter, the second one, is getting buffed by one. So still 5 points ahead. Really don't like to play the Crone here. If we drop the Geralt Igni in this lane, we are just getting rid of the shields. So he's not doing that much. If we play the Chiron now, it's not too great. Really want to keep that for later. Especially we should keep one of the Nekazi on the board. So let's go for the crown. Another 14 points. He's finally passing. We win the first round. Spawning another one. So chance is high that we are keeping one of the lesser fire elementals here, or one of the Arachas, and also spawning another Neka. We will start the game. We will take one of the two infantries with the caretaker. Oh no. How unlikely was that? Also getting... Wow. Super lucky. Oh, that might be the unluckiest draw ever. Chance to get the Neka was so low on the board. And then we're drawing two Nekas as well. This would be the only ones we have in the whole deck. So we're not spawning another one. Oh, that is really bad. So we're going for the caretaker here. Stealing the 11 points.
You can try to win them all, but you won't.
You talked enough.
The Siri. Which is great. We will then play the Chiron. Let's eat those poor infantries. Buffing the Nekas, of course. And no, we're not spawning another one, unfortunately. But we should know what we are up to.
What do you want of me?
Field medic is giving him Priscilla. We will keep the Geralt Igni until the last part. And then hit the poor infantries that are getting spawned. So 3-3. Not a problem. Let's go for the Neka here. Still 30 points ahead. No problem.
Nasty wounds those, but you'll live.
So there comes a poor infantry at 11 points. Still spawning another Neka. Let's hope that he's not using Mutagen or promote. Oh, that is bad. Priscilla back again. So even if we are clearing the poor infantry, he can use Priscilla to get that back. We will still be ahead here. So he would need, the other card would need to be super great for him. Well, let's try our luck here.
Damn it.
It'll be possible to win the round and then the whole game. Needs to play Priscilla again. Bomb, that is not doing much. So we win that game, despite getting triple Nekas.
Thank not me.
Oh yeah, I like that. Now clearing the poor infantry. Next up is the Skoyatil deck with Bruva Hook. Maybe playing some dwarf, that would be fun. So, let's see how that one is working. We have a Naka, Naka Varia, Ikimara, Giant Toad, Gaunter, Crone, and Chiron. So let's drop one of the Nakas here. No, don't want another Crone. Thank you. Geralt Ikni. We could risk to draw another card, but most likely I'm not that lucky. So let's just keep it that way. Normally I want to drop the Thunderbolt Potion here. But will we be lucky enough? Probably not. Still trying. Let's go. Just give me a good card. Got another Ikimara, so that was better than the Thunderbolt Potion. That was working out. Opponent needs to
Don't
start.
Take care of myself.
Why would you? You're getting the Roach and then it's back into the hand. I'm not sure if I like that move. Normally you should keep the Milfa for later in the game, so not sure why he was playing that right away. Maybe secret strategy. So Rehead spawning a command on your feet, which is fine. We'll drop the Nika Barrier here, get more Nikas into the deck. Bit afraid that he's otherwise killing that and we're not getting anything. He might play some spores on that. Aromancy. Going for... really the rain? No, you go for the frost. Yeah, there you go. Taking on the frost. Then let's go for the giant toad. We are dropping one of the Ikimaras. Drawing another card. Don't give me a crone. That is also not too great. So we're getting, of course, the Arhas out of the deck. Which is fine. But not too hot in particular. He's currently ahead, 7 points. But nothing too variable here. Blue Mountain Commando, get another Elf Mercenary.
Storm is
a special card. Play the clear skies, please. Rally effect, another Elf Mercenary.
Let's enjoy the weather.
And that the Spores Mutagens. He's using the Mutagens on the Elf Mercenary. Okay, and the Alirin. Well, that is quite a huge advantage for him right now. But if we, for example, play the Crown here, that will be 21 points. Just like that, and right there we are at 34 points. So that would be pretty good. We could also just stop the Geralt Igni, killing right now only 7 points, so we might wait a bit longer. And yeah, I would go for the Crown here right now. Death Roach, another 3 points. Stop that, spawning the other two from the deck. And we are still able to craft this lane here to 6 points each. Another Muta again, and this time he's buffing the Roach. So we would now be able to kill 14 points, which is of course better than just killing 7 points. The 14 points I like, really, and he might otherwise buff again, then we can't kill both. The Roach is of course coming back when he spawns another gold card on the board, but we will see about that.
A storm is coming. Let's enjoy the weather. Another
Mercenary, Mutagen, buffing. This time the Alirin. Up to 10 points. Still behind. Still behind. So we might take out one of the smaller units. So we have a higher chance to get a high value unit later in the game for the next round. Currently we are still 9 points ahead. He has spawned one of the weather cards. So let's eat the Arhas here. Also increasing the Neka then this way. We have a 14 points Kaivan.
I'll feed you to the crows!
Blue Mountain Commando.
Have strength,
Elf Mercenary
love.
Again. Rally effect. Unexpected. On another command on your feet.
Safe,
this one is dropping into the melee row, so not that great. 6 points ahead. We're just stopping the ghoul here so we can buff the lane with the guilds. That's good enough. Oh, he's taken one silver card. Another rally effect. And another vanguard.
Your tricks will not save
you. So that is 55 to 55. Not bad. Can drop the counter and then play the Gale, so we will win the round here.
My world, my world.
12 points ahead. If we buff, we are going ahead heavily. Yeah, that's not doing too much. We are still ahead. But he's drawing cards, so he might have a nice advantage for the next round.
Naivety is a fool's blessing.
So we might see now a pass. Will you do the pass? He's not doing the pass. You should do the pass here.
I'll feed you to the crows!
So what are you taking? Spawning that. Would be another command on your feet.
I was hoping you'd say that.
It's still far behind and we can now just pass. So he's only one card in advantage. If he's passing, and if he's passing now, he should have passed last round. So he's doing that. Doesn't make much sense. Like the Milfa for the start. That will also not making too much sense. We are keeping the shadow here, 6 points. We get the Naka at 8 points. And we get a Thunderbolt potion. Ooh, another one. I don't like that. Double Thunderbolt potion. That is not too hard. We are starting, of course. So we have one Naka there. Let's see how many do we have left. So far we had one. So still 3 left in the deck, which means we will now eat that one with the Akimara. Getting a 9-point snake on the board. So we have 29 points.
I do what I must.
Ooh, a long time no seen. That one is getting 3 strength whenever a command on your feet appears on his side. He was nerfed a bit in the past, so seeing not that much play right away. And I really like just to pass now. He needs to invest a lot of cards to overcome the 29 points. We will keep one unit on the board. And if we're getting lucky, we will keep the Naka as well. So we have 2 of them. We can use the double Thunderbolt potion. What are you going? Should have just got the Iglesias here for the first. He could have used that, then spawn the frost. Then he would only need to play one card to go ahead in points. So really he's playing some shitty play. Yeah, you will take not the frost, but you could have used that as the first card. After playing the Elias here. So he only has one card in the hand. We'll keep the shadow. We'll spawn another Naka, so 10 points. Ooh, and a caretaker, that is great. 6 cards left.
Enough of this farce. Bedry
and oh, what are you killing? That one, he's spawning the roach. Really wanted to get that. So with the caretaker, what can we steal? Probably not much. Blue Mountain Commando, Vanguard. That will be 10 points. That is quite a lot. That is not good. That will spawn 9. We don't have any good special cards. Yeah, so that's the best card to get here. 10 points on the board. 7 points ahead. He has 1 card. We will buff for another 8 points. Oh, nice to get that. It was out of cards. Alright, still losing. Double Thunderbolt potion is enough. And this is another victory with the deck. He played it very poorly. So guys, this will be the end of today's Gwent episode. I hope you have enjoyed our travel to the Consume and Spawn deck for the Monsters faction. If you have enjoyed the video, please give it a like and consider a subscription to the channel so you get notified when I will upload more content. Gwent content is coming multiple times per week, so check that out. And I'm also playing other card games like Hearthstone, Shadow Wars or Elder Scrolls Legends, so you can check that out as well if you like. See you then in the next episode and have a good night. Bye bye.